Another must-use tool for any Python programmer is Python Anywhere. Python Anywhere is a service, an online service, which gives you access to their servers for free. So having access to a server means having access to a computer which runs 24/7. And if you have access to a computer which runs constantly, you can do wonderful things in that computer with Python. So what exactly can you do on Python Anywhere? Well, you can write and run Python code on Python Anywhere. So through their computers, you can write programs. I'll show you how to do that. Then you can install Python libraries on their servers, so third-party packages, and you can also install Linux apps. So Python Anywhere uses servers, and these servers run on a Linux operating system, so you can install programs on that Linux computer. Python is already installed, so you don't have to install Python, but you can install Python libraries with pip. You can also deploy web apps. So if you develop a web app locally on your computer, you want to make that website, that web app, live. So for that, you need a server which runs 24/7, so that people can access your website in any time of the day. So you can upload your website on Python Anywhere and make it public. And lastly, on Python Anywhere, which is the focus of this lecture, on Python Anywhere you can schedule tasks. You can, in other words, you can schedule a Python script for execution at a particular time every day. So why is this useful? Well, I can mention some cases when you'd need to do that. For example, you want to send an email at a particular time every day. So you write the script that sends the email. The script simply sends one single email, and you can just schedule that script to be executed at a particular timestamp every day, and Python Anywhere will execute that script and the email will be sent according to the instructions in your Python code. Another use case of this scheduling functionality of Python Anywhere would be if you want to scrape data, you want to scrape a value every day at a particular time, and maybe save that value, for example, a stock price or the weather temperature, and you can save that in a text file. So you write a script that does those actions, and then you schedule that script. So let me give you a quick overview of Python Anywhere. Once you create a free account, you can see the dashboard, the consoles, the files, the web, tasks, and databases. Here on the dashboard, you have some shortcuts of these other menus. For example, if you want to create a console, you either go here in this area here, or you go to consoles, and then you create, for example, a Python console. So press on Python 3.8 or another version of Python, and that will immediately launch a Python interactive shell where you can write code. Some libraries are already installed, like pandas. Some other ones are not installed, but you can install them by first opening a bash console here and then doing pip 3.8 if Python 3.8 is what you're using. So pip 3.8 install, let's say speech recognition, that's a library for converting audio to text. So I have already installed this, and you can go back and then go to the Python console and import speech recognition. So that is the interactive shell, but you can also create Python files by going to the files menu and then going here down to files, and you can create a file, for example, hello.py, and press on new file. So that's the file we have just created. Here you can also write Python code and execute it using this run button. You might get this message if you have too many consoles open. So I have these two consoles, so I have to close one of them and then go to files because I'm on a free plan. So there are limitations with a free plan. And the limitations don't let you use too many consoles. So not a big deal. On the web menu, you can deploy web apps. So for example, I have uploaded this web app. And since I'm on free version, this expires every 3 months, so I have to press this button every 3 months in here. So that's an inconvenience, but for the free plan it's fine. Then you go to tasks. Here you can create a task. For example, I have created this task, but I'm going to delete it and show you how to create a new one. So this is the interface. Basically, you say that when you want the task to be executed, so the script, for example, at 10:00 UTC, so the time system is in UTC. You should be aware of that and calculate what your local time is related to UTC, so you find the correct time. Here now, you should put the path to the Python file. So you upload a Python file in here in files. For example, you upload it with this and then you find the Python scripts in your local system, and so the file will be uploaded in this directory. For example, let's say we uploaded this hello.py. You should know the path to this hello.py file. The path actually is this. It's /home/your username. In my case, it's rd123. Then /hello.py. So remember that and go to tasks again. So it was /home/rdit123/hello.py. That's the path to the file you want to execute at this particular time of the day. You can give a description if you like and then press create. That script will be executed at this time every day. So you can notice that the UTC time is this, but this time here was converted to my local time. So keep that in mind. There's also an option to create MySQL databases and PostgreSQL, although PostgreSQL requires a paid plan, but MySQL is free. And so that's it about Python Anywhere. I hope you find this useful and keep that in mind whenever you need to do some automation that you can rely on Python Anywhere. So I would really suggest this service. I'll talk to you in the next videos. See you.